now call upon Mr. Chandan Bhavnani, Executive Vice President of Yes Bank, to deliver his keynote with us this afternoon. Mr. Bhavnani.
Thank you so much, Rohan. Good evening, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here on the 50th SKOCH Summit, I'm sorry. I must commend SKOCH for bringing together leaders from diverse backgrounds to deliberate on how we can create a progressive, inclusive, and a future-ready India by 2030. Being a banker, I've been given the opportunity to speak about the inherent potential of blue economy and how investments in green sectors like agriculture, renewable energy, and water can fuel sustainable growth for India and its future generations. Water is one of the core elements that sustains life on Earth, and rivers and oceans have always been, they've always acted as a cradle for civilizations across millennia. And in today's modern perspective, water is a key growth indicator and also imbibed in all our developmental indices, putting it at the center of socioeconomic activities. The concept of blue economy is basically an extension of ability of water resources to support productivity and sustainable development by tapping at the vast opportunities that it has to offer. Oceans, with a current estimated value of $24 trillion US dollars and an annual value of $2.5 trillion USDs, which is greater than India's GDP, would continue to offer significant economic benefits, both in traditional areas of transportation, tourism, hydrocarbons, and fisheries, as well as in new fields of deep sea mining, renewable energy, and ocean biotechnology. With the land-based resources depleting fast to support the growing population, rampant efforts to expand economic exploitation of oceans is underway. All this will have serious impacts on oceans' natural role, both as a single most important absorber or a sink of carbon, and also as a replenisher of oxygen. The result of this will be accelerated global warming and climate change. A differentiated blue economy approach is needed to uniquely position India in achieving integration of economic growth with values of social inclusion and environmental sustainability, along with dynamic and innovative business models. Under the leadership of our Honorable Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, the Indian government has committed itself towards promoting blue economy. In fact, Mr. Modi also referred to the blue chakra in our flag as the next revolution, or the blue revolution under the ocean economy. Apart from water as a focus area, the government has also taken ambitious targets on achieving the nationally determined contributions under the Paris Agreement, including the renewable energy target of 175 gigawatts by 2022. This political will and leadership translates into signals for financial institutions to accelerate investments into sectors like water and clean energy, which are cross-cutting issues and are of immediate priority for India. There is also a huge business case in financing these green sectors, as a recent IFC report suggested that the potential of green investments or climate-related investments in India is estimated at about $3.1 trillion. In order to channelize finance to meet this mammoth development agenda, huge amounts of will, partnership, and collaboration is very critical to herald green capitalism. The next frontier now lies in creating a pipeline of bankable projects and converting these global efforts into local action, with financial institutions playing a key role of sustainability catalysts. Immediate action points for financial institutions to integrate climate considerations include: one, a very targeted investment approach towards climate-aligned sectors. Now, I'm again referring to the same IFC report, and I'll just talk about what is the potential of different sectors in clean economy, in green economy. So green buildings have a potential of $1.4 trillion. Renewable energy has a potential of $448 billion. Transportation infrastructure has a potential of $250 billion. Climate smart agriculture, a sector which feeds the entire population of India, $194 is the potential there. And in terms of climate smart urban water, $128 billion is the potential. Since these sectors do not attract large-scale investments currently, there's a need to specifically carve out targets in each of these areas. Yes Bank has committed itself to mobilize $5 billion towards climate action during COP21 with a specific focus on renewable energy. So we've taken up a voluntary target of financing or mobilizing finance for 5,000 megawatts of clean energy. With a well-defined climate finance strategy, the bank is looking to grow its portfolio by hardwiring sustainable development goals into core financing. Two, the second point would be innovative financial solutions to address climate and natural capital issues. Yes Bank has pioneered financial instruments that have kickstarted financial markets. The first green bond in India was released by Yes Bank, and that was way back in 2015. And today, the market is valued at $6.3 billion. Risk-sharing mechanisms is another way that we can look at. And this can be in form of facilitating finance for energy efficiency in MSMEs. So the government has already come out with a risk-sharing facility in which Yes Bank was the first private sector institution to partner with it. There's also innovative financing which is required in terms of blended financing. So in terms of blended financing, Yes Bank has developed a model through which it has channelized the CSR funds towards an NGO. And what this NGO basically does is, one, it increases the availability of finance, two, it improves the affordability of finance, and three, it improves the accessibility of finance. So what we've done is basically through CSR money, we've given it to an NGO which works with a local bank to provide loans at a lower interest to women self-help groups, helping them switch from diesel pumps to solar pumps. One, it affects in cleaner environment, and two, it also mainstreams them into the financial system. And as a result of this innovative financial structure, the basic benefits have been in form of aligning the interests of stakeholders in the value chain, across the value chain, which includes the rural cooperative bank, which includes the women salt pan farmers, which includes the NGO, and which also includes the donor. Distribution of the risk amongst the stakeholders. So because the loan is made available to the self-help groups, their skin is still in the game. They anyways have to repay the loan. The loan is available at a lower interest, so they are more inclined to taking and getting into the mainstream financial system. And also it intelligently uses grants to reduce the risks for the stakeholders. Beyond this, Yes Bank is also considering to pioneer innovative solutions in terms of blue bonds. So blue bonds are bonds dedicated to water infrastructure, particularly in industrial waste management and water management and civil supplies. And the second one is SDG-aligned bonds. So we are currently evaluating our alignment of the entire portfolio with sustainable development goals. And we may also look at having a specific bond for SDGs. Third important point is integrating climate risks within the enterprise risk management frameworks. So whenever we are giving out loans, we try and analyze that what is the social and the environmental impacts, and how is it that we can reduce or mitigate the social and the environmental impacts. And that is led primarily by our environmental and social policy, which acts as the key driver. The fourth important point is implementing unique, scalable, and sustainable CSR projects to create positive impact. Water security is a CSR focus area for Yes Bank, and it affects livelihoods of millions by reducing poverty, and promoting economic growth and environmental sustainability. Additionally, water crisis in India is a huge, with 63.4 million Indians not having access to clean and safe drinking water. Yes Bank is trying to work on the demand side solutions of this water deficit through partnerships. One is with the Indian Railways to provide safe and clean drinking water at 1,000 railway stations. And this is again a voluntary commitment that we've taken up. And this is particularly in the D and E categories where the commercial scale of selling water is not possible. Therefore, this water is provided at no cost, so it is clean, safe, and free. And this voluntary commitment is for 1,000 railway stations, of which we've already achieved about 35%. And additional 150 community water filters have also been set up across India. We are also working in Delhi to set up water ATMs, which also connect directly to livelihood, and they supplement the livelihood of the local people, where the water is sold at a very minimal cost, and people are then selling water through these water ATMs. The water solution is provided by basically a social startup partner and is implemented through a world patent technology of textile coating to manufacture low-cost, zero-discharge water filters. Since inception in 2014, this project for the bank has been providing clean and safe drinking water. And till now, there are about 50 million people who've benefited from this project, which is a huge amount. 50 million is like, you can have 15 Mongolias and 50 million. So that's how huge an impact is. Pre and post intervention surveys are conducted to calculate social impact value. And interestingly, the social impact through each rupee that is being invested in this program results in an economic benefit of 7.43 rupees. Just to conclude, I would say that emerging sectors such as water and clean energy and evolving financial instruments such as green bonds and blue bonds can play a key role in driving green capitalism, which can help India achieve its development and climate goals by 2030. For this, social and environmental concerns need to be integrated with economic concerns. The finance sector, which is the backbone of economy, needs to look beyond conservation, beyond conservative business perspectives, and needs to really innovate and invest in establishing successful business models through financial innovation and financing innovations. Thank you.